Welcome everyone. Thank you for joining me for today's practice. Today is yin yoga for the upper body. If you do have some props, please have them handy. So bolster, block, maybe a blanket. They're not necessary because we're only really using it for the beginning, and maybe you might want to use it a bit later on, but if you don't have them, don't worry about it. Just lie down on your back for this first pose. Make sure you're nice and warm. So be cozy, maybe have some socks on. I'm going to keep mine on. So let's make a start straight away. So we're going to start with the bolster lengthways. And just move your hips just a little bit away. So it's probably about 20 centimeters away from the edge of the bolster. And then lie back. So it's just hitting just the upper, the lower back into the middle part of the back. And then you could just keep your legs crossed. But if you feel comfortable to do so, take the soles, the feet together. And then this is somewhere you might pop a block or a blanket underneath your head if you want it to be lifted up a little bit more. Otherwise, just let the head rest back and arms down by your side. Closing down the eyes. And starting to draw the attention to your breathing. Feeling the tips of the shoulders drop down towards the mat. Back of the neck long. And in this very early part of the class, starting just checking in with yourself, noticing where you're at, how you're feeling, how your body's feeling. And whatever's here for you, just holding that with kindness. Starting to gently lengthen into your breathing. And if you've got the bolster underneath you, you might feel the openness that creates. So it encourages the muscles in between the ribs to open up and release. And now, if you don't have a blanket underneath the head, I'm going to ask you to interlace the fingers at the base of the head. So you're going to cradle the base of the head and then just let your head rest back down. We'll let the elbows point up for a moment. So you're just having a sense of lengthening the back of the neck. Just continuing with that long, smooth breath. So you're trying to evenly breathe in and evenly breathe out. So with your hands, just very gently creating a bit of traction along the neck. So you're pulling the base of the head away from the tops of the shoulders, tops of the shoulders, pulling away from the base of the head. Just another few breaths like this. Just for the last few breaths, just relaxing that traction down, but letting those elbows open out. So you're letting the elbows fall open, but keeping the fingers interlaced. Noticing the fullness of the lungs as you inhale. That natural little pause at the top before you exhale. One more full breath here. And use your hands, gently lift the head up and then release those hands, release the head back down, bring the forearms down to the mat, and then just very gently starting to make your way back up to a seated position. And springing the legs together, popping the bolster off to the side so it's out of the way, coming over the legs. And make your way back into child's pose. If you can, knees together, or if you would prefer, just have the knees wide. It's your choice. And we'll just take one hand on top of the other, rest the forehead down. Just breathing into the lower back. We'll just take a few breaths here just to allow the spine to resettle before we take our next pose. Just feeling the heaviness of the hips. And then coming up onto all fours, setting up the knees underneath the hips and wrists underneath the shoulders. You could have a blanket underneath your shins if you need a bit more support for your knees. And then start to walk the hands away. So we're coming into our happy puppy pose here. You could take your chin or your forehead. A little bit of pressure down through the tops of the shins. Armpits wrapping in slightly towards one another. Tailbone reaches back as you inhale. As you exhale, seeing if that the chest can release down towards the mat. We're going to transition down onto our belly. So come onto the forearms as you start to shift the weight forward, lying all the way down onto your belly. Place one hand on top of the other. We're just going to lie down for a few moments in stillness. Just allow the heels to fall away from one another. Noticing any residual sensation or feedback from the pose we've just been working on. And then let's come up onto the forearms as if you're coming into your Sphinx. But then we're going to work into our broken wing pose. So take that right arm out to the side. Make sure the elbow stays above the shoulder or in line with the shoulder. You might pop a block or a blanket underneath your head as you turn the head to the left. Use that left hand and we're going to roll over onto the right side of the body.
And you might be able to reach this left foot back. And I've got that bolster conveniently there. You could pop your foot on the bolster or pop it down to the ground. If either of those just doesn't work, you could just rest it down on the mat. So finding the position that feels good. We're opening up that right upper corner of the chest into the front of the shoulder. If you don't need this left hand down on the ground, you can wrap it behind the back. And if it feels comfortable to do so, close down the eyes. Notice how you use the breath to meet that rising sensation in the body. And it's almost like you yield into the sensation to allow it to release. And if it feels like a real struggle and there's a lot of resistance, as long as there's not sharp pain, you might want to use a mantra, something very simple like let go. And as you exhale, internally saying to yourself, let go. Five more full breaths here. Gently release that back arm if it's behind you. Just take your time and roll onto the belly. Just being really mindful. And we're going to take both arms down by the sides of the body. Just turn the head into the opposite direction. Big toes together. Heels fall away from one another. Allowing the shoulder to resettle back into its position. It's a little bit more curved forward in this position. And there might be residual tingling or kind of slightly prickly sensation. It's indicating just energy starting to move through that part of the body. And then let's bring that forearms forward again as if you're coming into your Sphinx. And we'll go to the other side. We're going to take that left arm out to the side. Turn the head to the right. Remember, option to take a block or a blanket underneath it. Rolling over onto the left side, bringing that right foot back behind you. Maybe popping a bolster underneath this right foot if you've got one. Just making sure you haven't squeezed that left elbow down. Sometimes happens. You want to keep it in line with the shoulder or slightly higher. And then if you would like to wrap this right arm behind the back, just go for that. And if you feel comfortable to do so, closing down the eyes. Listening in for any pockets of space that start to open up, particularly on that exhale. And if it feels like it's supporting you, you might draw on that internal mantra. You could try let go again, or you might want to try something else, something like soften. So as you inhale, make space, exhale, soften. Just noticing if you do need to back out, if one side's a little bit tighter than the other, you might need to just release a little bit or release that back hand back down. So just being in the pose in a space where you can comfortably breathe. Five more full breaths. Gently release that back hand and carefully rolling back onto the belly. Just take your time. Bring both arms down by your side, turning the head to the left. Big toes together, let the heels fall away from one another. Just observing the breath, observing the body. And then let's bring the hands underneath the shoulders. Bring the head back to center. Just very gently pressing yourself onto all fours. Just take a moment to find your tabletop position. We'll tuck the toes under and we're coming into our down dog only for a moment. So we're just lifting the hips up, just taking a little moment in your down dog. This is just a transition. Looking forward to the hands, step the right foot to the outside of the right hand, left foot to the outside of the left hand. Your feet are turning out a little bit and then sitting down into your deep yogic squat here. This is somewhere where you could sit on a block or a bolster, completely fine. If you don't have props and it's not working, then sit down and take this variation. Coming back up if that's where you are, and I'm going to turn to face you. So we're going to start with a pretty active variation. Elbows pressing out, palms of hands pressing together. So hips are heavy, crown of the head reaching up. Feel free to stay here. I'm going to offer a variation which is going to open up more of the shoulders, the back of the shoulders and upper back. You're going to take the back of the left hand to the side of the waist and then hook the elbow to the inside of the thigh. Same thing with the right hand, back of the hand to the waist, hook the elbow to the inside of the thigh. And then let the hips be heavy. Find the breath. So gentle squeezing in with the inner thighs, very gentle. Little bit of pressing out with the elbows. Breathing into that space,
into the tips of the shoulders, along the ridge of the upper back. And if it's too much doing two, you could also always do one at a time. And then gently release one hand out, other hand out. And we're just going to take a little forward fold, so back of the hands just behind the feet, and then let the upper body drape forward. If you've got your bottom down, you can just lean over the legs. And just take three more full breaths here. And then start to come upright with the torso. Use your hands to come down onto the hips. Remove your props if you've got some props. So extend the legs out long for a moment. Give the legs a little bit of a wriggle out just to release the knees. And then let's bend the knees once again. And taking your left leg underneath. So I'm going to mirror you now. So it's left leg underneath, right leg on top. Try to get both sitting bones down. And if this doesn't work for you, you could try to elevate your hips by sitting up on a block, or you could extend the bottom leg long, okay? So we're going for our Gomukhasana, or cow face. Take that left arm up towards the ceiling, place the left hand onto the upper back. Right arm reaches back, and you're gonna try to grip and do a monkey grip with your fingers. So walking that right hand up, left elbow's pointing up towards the ceiling, lower ribs relaxing in. Once you've found your position, feeling free to close the eyes. We've already done a lot of work through the upper body, so hopefully you're feeling a little bit more open already, that this is quite a strong position and tends to bring a lot of intense sensations. So just noticing how you can meet that rising sensation with the breathing. Trying to soften on the exhale. If possible, keep the hands interlinked. We're just going to start to lean forward over the legs just for a couple of breaths. Gently release those hands and then start to come forward even further if you can. This is somewhere, if you had your bolster, you had your blocks, you could rest your head down if that feels good for you. Noticing that feedback in the upper body now that we've unraveled the arms. Last couple of breaths. Is there anything you can let go of here in these last few moments? And then starting to walk the hands back up and hands behind you. Let's uncross the legs. Just take the legs long for a little minute and give them a bit of a shake out. And then bending the knees back up again. And now let's take the right leg underneath and the left leg on top. trying to get both sitting bones down. Remember your options. You can sit up on a block or extend that bottom leg long. And we're going to take that right arm up towards the ceiling. Place the hand onto the upper back and then take that left hand back behind you and start to walk it up, trying to find your monkey grip here. And once you're there, try to square the shoulders to the front. Option to close the eyes or gaze towards the tip of the nose. It might have been easier to do this on one side than the other. Those lower ribs relaxing in. Thinking about growing up through both sides of the waist. Full breath. And if you can, continue to hold the grip behind you as you start to go forward over the legs for a couple of breaths. And gently release the arms. Just bringing them down in front of you, starting to walk them forward to where you can. Just observing that feedback, maybe feeling it all along the arms, into the shoulders. Upper body getting heavier with each exhale. So last three breaths here. And then starting to walk the hands back up. Release the legs out long. Just making sure that you've got space to go back behind you. Just give the legs a little bit of a wriggle out. And then lie down on your back. We're going to take the legs long. We're not quite at our shavasana yet, but we'll just have the legs long. Take our shavasana position for a few breaths before we take our final pose. Just one more breath here. And open the eyes up, bend the knees, and we're going to take the arms out into your cactus position. Arms up to shoulder height, and then lift the hips up, bring them slightly over towards the left, and then lift them up to your tabletop. So we're going to drop them down over to the right. Now this is somewhere you could have your bolster underneath here or your block, if that feels like it's supportive for you. And then let that left shoulder blade be heavy. And you can either look straight up or turn your head slightly towards the left. Just allow the legs to be heavy. Can you release the jaw? Soften the tongue and the back of the throat.
bring the feet back towards the center, bring the head back to the center. Feet flat, lift the hips up, over to the right slightly. Bring the legs up to your tabletop and drop them over to the left. That right shoulder blade heavy now. Head can look straight up or turn slightly towards the right. Just noticing any unnecessary effort that you can let go of. And that might mean you just let go of the idea of the shape of the body. Five more full breaths. And then let's bring the feet back to the center of the mat. And coming back to the center with the head, hips back towards the middle. Coming into your shavasana, if you do have your bolster, you might want to pop it underneath your knees. It's quite lovely to have that just to release the lower back. Make sure you're nice and warm. So if you've got a blanket or a jumper, pop that on. Take some time to make yourself feel comfortable. Completely surrendering the weight of the body. Just feeling supported by the ground underneath you. Just allowing yourself to soften. Whole body, just letting go. And resting here for the next few minutes. So please feel free to stay here for as long as you would like to. Thank you for joining me for today's practice. Namaste.